Welcome to our annual daily review of the best modular helmets of 2023. And again, it's time to answer that burning question, what helmet is the best helmet of 2023? We've tested all the modular helmets from the top brands, and in this video you'll find out which helmet can call itself the best. So, stay tuned. Hi everyone, I'm Tom from Champion Helmets here, and welcome to our channel. And in today's video, we're going to discuss the best modular helmets. And we have some new contestants this year, so let's see if they're able to shake up last year's top 10. During this guide, we compare the best modular helmets out there and check if the statements made by the manufacturers about these helmets are true. And we put in a lot of time and effort into this guide so that you get to see an honest review and test-based facts, whether they're marketing language or personal opinions. So, if you appreciate this effort, subscribe to our channel and like the video so we can continue to test helmets out on the road and create in-depth reviews for you guys. And before we begin, first a few things in general. Modular helmets are designed to provide a balance between the protection of a full face helmet and the convenience of an open face helmet. Modular helmets are super comfortable and therefore great for touring. And modular helmets are specifically made for touring purposes and riding in the city, or a combination of these two. Now, if you want to ride with a chin bar open, you will need to buy a modular helmet that has a PJ certification. If your helmet is not PJ certified and you ride with a chin bar open, you're taking a safety risk and you're also risking a fine. The helmets we will be covering in our guide this year are the Neotec 2, the Sport Modular, the Evo GT, the N105, the C5, the Tour Modular, and three new helmets, the ExoTec, R491, and the Advent X. We have divided this review in several chapters, and we start by looking at the material the helmets are made of. Then we take a look at the weight per helmet. This is followed by a close examination of the visor features, and then our rider will take each helmet out on the road and see how it performs. During the road test, we will see how well the helmets ventilate and how quiet they are. Then our test rider will share his experience on comfort for each helmet. And in the last parts, we discuss the bells and whistles these helmets are equipped with. We conclude our guide with a clear ranking where all these helmets stand. And from there, it will be up to you to decide what is important for you. Okay, let's dive in. We start the guide with an important part, the material, and for this part we look at two different points. The first point is what the outer shell is made of, and the second is how many outer shell sizes the helmet comes in. This is something that is often overlooked, but it's very important. The more outer shell sizes a helmet has, the more compact the helmet sits around the head, and the more comfortable it is. And in addition, a more compact helmet also looks better. Now, let's look at the results for material. The Sport Modular, the R491 and the 1005 Ultra Carbon immediately take the lead in this part. The Sport Modular and the X1005 owe their excellent score to the three outer shell sizes and their carbon outer shell. The R491 because of its fiberglass shell and four outer shell sizes. The Neotec 2 and the Tour Modular also did well in this part. The shell of these helmets is fiberglass composite and they come in three outer shell sizes. The ExoTec, the Advent X come in only two outer shell sizes, but this is compensated by their full carbon shell. Furthermore, we see that the Shark Evo GT and the Nolan N105 Plus finish at the bottom with a score of only 2.5 stars. Let's continue to the weight and see if HIV, HGC and X-Lite can maintain their lead. We continue with the weight of the helmets. Weight is an important part that is often underestimated. A lighter helmet prevents fatigue in the neck and feels more comfortable and improves your overall riding experience. Modular helmets are generally on the heavier side due to the flip-up mechanism. To properly compare all the helmets, we weigh them all on the same scale in a size M. We see that the Sport Modular outperforms all with a weight of just 1341 grams, which is extremely lightweight for a modular helmet. Using carbon really paid off for AGV, as carbon helmets are generally lighter compared to fiberglass helmets and polycarbonate helmets. As a result, the Sport Modular earns a perfect 5-star score for the weight. The ExoTec and the Advent X also did well in this part, finishing as the only two helmets in the 1500 gram range, thus earning these helmets a great 4 stars for weight. The other helmets are all above 1600 grams, and the X-Lite, AGC and Nolan even above 1700 grams. This in itself is remarkable considering that the 1005 Ultra Carbon is made of full carbon, which should make the helmet extremely light, but in this case it obviously doesn't work, which is very interesting. This was a bit disappointing from the X-Lite. So far the AGV Sport Modular has been the strongest, but we are far from finished, so let's move on to the next part. We have arrived at the part where we zoom in on the visor, the mechanism and the visor features. To determine a score on the visor, we look at all kinds of properties of the visor. In doing this, we follow the visor matrix. One option is obviously not the other option, and therefore some features will be judged more heavily than others. Examples are whether or not the helmet is pinlock prepared, and if the pinlock is included in the box. It's even better if this is a max vision pinlock. Another example is the visor mechanism. Is it a simple lever, or does it have an advanced spring mechanism? The list goes on. Now let's have a look at how our helmets performed for the visor part. The ExoTech, the Advent X and the NeoTech 2 earned a full 5 stars for this part. The NeoTech 2 owes it to its advanced visor mechanism, and the ExoTech and the Advent X thanks to the free extra dark smoke visor included in the box. These helmets offer everything you could expect for the visor part. The same qualities as the NeoTech 2 also apply to the Schubert C5, but the C5 had a slightly less advanced visor mechanism. The Shoei's advanced spring mechanism was better, and this minimal difference was enough to take the lead. Other than that, we don't really see any major differences, and every other helmet earned 4 stars for this part. So they are pretty much on par, with some outliers, but now that we're done in the studio, let's see how these helmets perform out on the road. Before we begin the road test, first a brief explanation on how we collect our data. On the left side you see a white thermometer. This is connected to a sensor in the helmet. This thermometer shows the inside temperature in the helmet. In the top center you see the decibel meter, which is connected to a microphone that's placed near our rider's ear. This records a sound the same as our rider hears it. And on the right we see a phone that displays wind speed and the outside temperature. This is connected to a wind meter mounted on our bike. In the middle, we see the dashboard showing our rider's speed. We did all our tests on the same motorcycle on long stretches of highway, with an average wind speed of about 120 and a riding speed of around 130 km per hour, to make sure we're comparing apples with apples. With that out of the way, let's start the road test. During the first part of the road test, we look at the noise, and good noise isolation is always nice, of course. But especially for touring helmets, and especially on longer touring trips, you want the helmet to be as quiet as possible to travel comfortably. To determine the score for noise, we look at the average decibel reading over 5 km of highway. The lower the number of decibel, the quieter the helmet, and the higher the number of stars the helmet scores. According to our matrix, a score less than 98 decibels gives the ultimate score of 5 stars. Let's see how our contenders did in terms of noise. Looking at the result for noise, we see pretty big differences. At the top, we see the Arfa 91 with an excellent score of 95 decibel. With this score, the Arfa 91 is not only the quietest modular helmet in this test, but it also took the title for the quietest helmet we've ever tested. For this, the HEC earns a full 5 stars. When we talk about a quiet helmet, it's safe to say it doesn't get any quieter than this. This is quite remarkable, as modular helmets are often noisier than full-face helmets because they have seams and cracks. So very well done by HEC. The Arfa 91 is followed by the C5, which is still 3 decibels louder. And I know what you're thinking, 3 decibels doesn't sound like much, but each decibel difference is clearly audible for the rider. The Schubert is followed closely by the AGV Tour Modular, which had a very nice reading of 99 decibel. So these top 3 helmets are the absolute best if you're looking for a quiet helmet. Notable here is that we find the X-Lite and the Nolan at the bottom of the list again. Also surprising are the scores of the Advent X and the ExoTech, which have always performed well, until now. Unfortunately, in terms of noise, they were weaker with the 102 and 103 decibel reading. To put things into perspective, we're still talking about the very best modular helmets available today, so those values are not that bad at all. With entry-level helmets, you're quickly in at 107 or 109 decibel range, which again highlights the exceptional strong results of the top 3. Very interesting results for noise. Okay, great. Now we move on to another important part of the helmet, the ventilation. To determine the score for the ventilation, we compare the temperature inside the helmet to the outside temperature. A well-ventilated helmet efficiently removes heat and manages to keep the inside temperature equal to the outside temperature. Now, first a brief explanation on how we determine scores for ventilation. When we look at our ventilation matrix, we also use bandwidth to determine our score. If it is no warmer inside the helmet than the outside temperature, we speak of excellent ventilation. The lower the temperature difference, the better the ventilation and the more stars a helmet gets. Now, let's jump in to see the results. If you put all the competitors in a chart, we see that the NeoTech 2 and the Sport Modular and the Evo GT finish at the top. That's because the inside temperature in these helmets was 1 degree cooler than the outside temperature. This is an excellent result, and with that score, all 3 helmets earned a maximum score of 5 stars. Notable here is the Shark Evo GT. This helmet was at the bottom of the list in previous criteria, but absolutely peaks in the ventilation segment due to its perfect score. So very well done by Shark. Most of the other helmets have the same inside temperature as outside temperature, or are 0.5 degrees hotter. The ExoTech Evo Carbon is 1.5 degrees hotter on the inside compared to the outside temperature. And this is the only helmet that is 1 degree hotter than the outside air. We note that all of our helmets scored well. It's worth mentioning that the difference here are already a lot smaller than the noise segment. If you look at all these helmets and their somewhat budget-friendly alternatives, you see really big differences. But again, we're talking about the absolute best of the best. So it was good to see that they deliver good results, and in some cases even excellent results for ventilation. Okay, so much for the ventilation, and this brings us to comfort. This is the only subjective part of our road test, but actually includes much more than just comfort. In this part, we assess subjective criteria such as comfort, wind resistance, the feel of the inner liner, the behavior out on the road, the finish, and the overall feel of the helmet. These are criteria that are difficult to capture in hard numbers. Therefore, for this part, we rely on the more than 15 years of riding experience of our test rider. Our rider has tested all these helmets and can therefore make a comparison like no other. We have extensively tested all these helmets in an individual review, and they've received points for their comfort. We've collected all these scores and put them down in a graph for you. Our most comfortable modular helmets are the Shoei Neotech 2 and the Schubert C5. Both helmets scored the ultimate score of 5 stars on comfort. About the Shoei, our rider told us that the finish and attention to detail is exceptional. As an example, Shoei used a softer material for the inner lining behind the ear than the rest of the liner. This is because this is a more sensitive area. He thought this was typical of Shoei's attention to detail. He also described the helmet's behavior on the highway as very refined. The C5 owes its top score thanks to its quality inner lining. As an example of the quality of Schubert, our rider mentioned the hidden anti-roll-off system under the liner, which he described as brilliant. This highlights how far the Germans are willing to go for safety, even if it's not visible to the average rider. He stated that this is typical of Schubert's quality and comfort. Most of the helmets we compare in his guide almost all had a score of 4 stars, which is a strong result. Also worth mentioning is the score of the Sport Modular, which scored so strongly in the weighted material, but our test rider was not impressed with the feel out on the road. It did feel light, but the position of the chin strap liner was not optimal. According to our test rider, as a result, it scores half a star lower than its direct competitors. Okay, great, we have arrived at the features of the helmets. In this section, we look at the bells and whistles our helmets are equipped with. In determining scores, we've taken into account the options that riders have asked us about the most. These include options for communication systems, the quality of the flip-up mechanism, the certification the helmet has, and whether or not it's been wind-tested, and much more. In our features matrix, you can see how many points are awarded for each option. This makes it very clear how the helmets get their stars for the features. Now let's see the results. We immediately see that the C5 scores 4.5 star. This is due to its extensive communication capabilities with built-in speakers, a built-in microphone, a completely hidden plug-and-play communication system, superior finish, its excellent flip-up mechanism, the anti-roll-off system and the PJ and 2206 certification, and the fact that it's been wind tunnel tested. So this helmet has just about every option that matters. The anti-roll-off system gives it that little edge that puts the C5 at the top. Then this time we see that the Nolan and X-Lite suddenly come out strong. They actually also had all the options we saw in the other strong helmets and offered the ability to customize the liner. Disappointing were the Advent X and the Shark Evo GT, which were not wind tunnel tested and had slightly weaker finish. Now that each component has been discussed, let's see how much the helmets performed across the board. Ideally, we want a helmet that performs well on all components. We will now look at the performance of each helmet by category. This will give us a great idea of how the helmets compare to each other. We can see that the C5 and the Shoei Neotech 2 have a consistent strong score across the board, followed closely by the Arfa 91 and the Sport Modular. The LS2 and the Scorpion had some nice outliers, such as the visor and the weight. Furthermore, we see that the Shark and the X-Lite are also still in the race. However, there is one last important aspect that plays a huge role in determining which modular helmet can call itself the best, and that is of course the price. What happens when we weigh in the price? Okay, great. We've already seen a lot of interesting data and certain outliers on certain segments. This last segment is all about value. If two helmets perform the same, but one of them has a lower price, it relatively scores better. And therefore we look at two variables when we determine the value for money. The first is the average number of stars. This mainly says something about the quality. And the second is the amount in euros you pay per star. This mainly says something about the value for money. These two variables are both used in our formula to determine the price quality score. And this score is the last component we will look at before arriving at our final ranking. Okay, with this out of the way, let's see how our helmets do. At the very top, we find the Shoei Neotech 2. It gets the highest price quality bonus of 4.4 stars. And then we see the Scorpion in second place with a nice price quality bonus of 4. Of our top 5 here, we can say that they score consistently strong in almost every part. And this is exactly what we want to see. Looking further at our Sport Modular, we see that thanks to its high price tag, it earns a bonus of 2.2. Lower on the list, we see the Tour Modular, the Shark, the Nolan and the X-Lite, which did not score very well across the board, pushing down both their average star score as well as their euro per star amount. Now that we have covered the value for money, we have all our data we need to proceed to our final conclusion. Okay, so we gathered all the data, added everything up, and now it's time to come to our final verdict. We are finally going to find out which helmet can call itself the very best modular helmet of this year. To keep things exciting, we'll start at the bottom. In 10th place, we start with the Nolan N105 Plus, which was strong parts were the visor and the ventilation and comfort, but scored weakly on the noise, material and weight. Actually, the same applies for the Shark EVO GT in 9th place. In 8th place was the X-Lite, which was strong on the material, visor, on comfort and on ventilation. In 7th place is the AGV Tour Modular. This helmet was actually consistently strong in all areas, was nowhere the best, but always competed with the top helmets. Only on material and weight did the helmet perform slightly weaker. Then we move on to 6th place. There we see our newcomer, the LS2 Advent X Carbon. This helmet did very well overall and offers excellent value for money. Now, let's move on to our top 5. The first helmet we find there is a Scorpion Exotech EVO Carbon, which performed great on the visor and weight and slightly weaker on material. In 4th place is the AGV Sport Modular, which scored very well across the board but was penalized in the value for money. In other words, they overpriced it. Otherwise, it is absolutely solid in terms of performance. Now, our top 3. In 3rd place, we find the new Arfa 91, which performed great on all parts and it's a true all-rounder. And on top of that, it took the special title of quietest helmet we have ever tested. So very well done by HDC. That leaves only 2 helmets, the Schubert C5 and the Shoei Neotech 2. Then the burning question, which is the best modular helmet of this year, the Shoei or the Schubert? And the answer to this question is the Shoei Neotech 2. This helmet narrowly trumps the C5 thanks to its more outer shell sizes, better visor mechanism and better ventilation. But on the other side, the C5 was better on the sound and features components. So it was a very intense and equal battle between these two, with the Shoei Neotech having a slight edge over the C5. Depending on what you find important. Well, this is it. It was very exciting, but the Shoei Neotech 2 stays ahead of the C5 by a nose length and can proudly call itself the very best modular helmet of 2023. This concludes our search for the best modular helmet of this year and brings us to the end of our champion data review. We went through all the helmets carefully and our test rider tested them out on the road with our measurement equipment, giving us the winner based on actual values rather than opinions. Although most of the helmets performed well, Shoei's Neotech 2 performed the best. Our newcomers this year managed to shake things up, but not enough to push the Neotech 2 off the throne. Want to learn more about the Neotech 2, the C5 or the Arfa 91 or any of our top 10 modular helmets? Then don't forget to like the video and subscribe to our channel, where you can watch more daily reviews and road tests like these. Also check out championhelmets.com, where we always offer the lowest price guarantee and have great discount bundles. If you have any more questions or need help choosing a helmet, don't hesitate to contact us. My name is Stone from Champion Helmets, thanks for watching and until next time!